Guess who's back? Back again. Shady's back. Tell a friend. Guess who's back? 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 Welcome to Real Quick Vape Reviews, where I tell you everything you need to know with no BS added. My name is Izzy, and today we're doing a 150 watt upgradable box mod. This is the Clouper T8. The Clouper T8 is a 150 watt box mod manufactured by the same company that made the first Hanna clones, Clouper. I received this Clouper T8 from easypeasyvape.com. On their website, it's going for $89.99, very affordable and almost $30 cheaper than its rival, the IPv3. Inside the box is a bag of spare parts, a mini screwdriver, a user manual, a card of authenticity, a micro USB cable, and the device. The T8 is a medium-sized box measuring out to 102mm tall and 55mm wide, made out of an anodized aluminum that comes in black, silver, red, and blue. On one side are the buttons, and on the other is the venting. On the front, we have a laser-etched Clouper T8 and a bright LED screen. On the back is a dimpled design resembling that of a Galaxy S5. And all around the mod, there are chamfered edges that make it easier to hold. The mod looks quality built. But one thing to note is that when carrying this in my bag, the anodized finish came off on some parts, and this was just from being inside my bag, in its own pocket. On the side are three buttons, one fire button, and two adjustment buttons. I have experienced no button rattle, which is a plus, and the buttons are clicky with a nice texture you can feel. You can turn the mod on and off with a standard 5 button click, and you can adjust the wattage by clicking up or down in 0.1 watt increments up to 100, and after that in 1 watt increments. And don't worry, when holding down the adjustment button, the scroll is quite fast. Up top is the screw adjusted brass 510. Around the 510 is an indented juice well, and the 510 does have cutouts, so all your devices will have airflow. I would much rather have a spring-loaded 510, but the screw adjustment isn't much of a hassle, and it fits almost all my atomizers flush. On the front is a bright LED screen, showing the wattage, voltage, resistance, device temperature, battery life, and an unnecessary puff counter. The device temperature, in my opinion, is a great safety feature. If your mod gets too hot to the point of unsafe vaping, it just won't fire. All the usual safety features are included, such as short protection and low power protection, to make sure you're not running your batteries down too far. The screen itself, like I said, is bright and large enough to see all you need. Performance-wise, the T8 has met all of my needs. I almost never go above 100 watts. Hell, I barely go over 60 watts. But when I need to, this thing does put out. But it's another one of those theoretical 150 watts, where you have to build it at a certain resistance to get the full power. This device has a voltage range of 1.5 to 7.6 volts, with a 20 amp limit and an ohm range of 0.15 to 4 ohms. So according to my calculations, you can only reach the max wattage if you build at exactly 0.38 ohms. So if you thought about getting this and throwing your 0.1 ohm quad coil to run at 150 watts, you may be a little disappointed. For me, it does what I need it to do. Battery life on this device is wild. I'm an average vapor that vapes around 50 watts, and at that power, it lasted me around an entire week and sometimes more. The battery cover is held on by two strong magnets that keep your cover from rattling at all, and inside are two spring 18650 battery holders. The only thing I don't like about the battery life is how I still have to use an external charger to charge my batteries. The micro USB port at the bottom is only for updating the firmware of the chip, but that's also where this thing may shine. This device is upgradable through micro USB, so further down the road you may be able to upgrade the wattage limit, but at this time, after having this for a while, I still haven't seen any upgrades. Overall, the Clouper T8 is an awesome box mod that can perform when you need it to. With a nice LED display, great safety features, wild battery life, sleek, stylish look, and upgradable firmware that'll keep it from falling behind, but the easily scratched finish, conditional 150 watts, and some unneeded screen features that keep it from scoring perfect. This device has been my all-day carry though, and I have to give it a 4.2 out of 5. Once again, thanks for watching, subscribe and like for more. My name is Izzy, and this was your Real Quick Vape Review. And yes, I am back. I was sick the past couple of weeks, but I'm back for good this time. I'll see you guys next time.